In this video, I'm going to be teaching you how to install a game plugin. Starting off, open SimTools. This is your home screen. Any plugins that you have installed will appear here. To install a new plugin, go down to the bottom right and click on Plugin Manager. Find the plugin for the game you have installed and click Install. Click Yes and read patching notes if they are available. These will tell you what to do in order for your game plugin to work properly. If nothing pops up, you're good to go. From here, you're going to choose the location where your game is installed. For me, it's in my C drive, and from there you can see that Live for Speed is right here. Click OK, and your plugin's all installed. You can also install a plugin zip file by dragging and dropping it into the home screen of SimTools. You will either take a plugin file downloaded off the SimTools website or an already downloaded plugin file, and drag and drop it into the homepage of SimTools. Now that we've installed our plugin, let's check out the different configurations that are available. By clicking the button on the top left, it takes you to the web page for your specific plugin. At the top of this page, you will see data about your game. Below that, there are patching notes, what motion, vibe, and dash is supported. Available options for your plugin are highlighted. Below this, there's the plugin change log. This shows you the time and date that changes were made to your specific plugin. Let's go back to SimTools. On the bottom left, you will see the vibe settings. From these settings, you can configure things like butt kickers and transducers to immersify your experience. Now let's look at the dash settings. These settings allow you to configure things like car dashboards, speedometers, and speed fans. Now let's take a look at our motion settings. Within your motion settings, you have a total of 18 axes you can configure. Most people use axis set A, but B and C are both available. You have three options when saving your configurations. By clicking Save, it saves your settings to the selected profile. By saving as default, you save your configurations to a default profile for that plugin only. By saving as global, you save it to a global profile that can be used for any plugin of the same type. After a global profile has been saved, those configurations will be used as a starting point for any new installed plugins of the same type. To test settings, click Test Settings. Within here, you can move the sliders and change the values to ensure that your motion is working properly. To stop testing, click Stop Testing. The min-max data input source relates to the values in your min-max tuning. By selecting output type, it allows you to assign the type of output your axis requires. To enable and disable motion altogether, use the switch above the axis assignments. All configurations will be saved to the selected profile. To change between profiles, use the drop-down menu in the top right. If available, auto mode will allow you to change between profiles by changing vehicles in-game. The copy, rename, and delete buttons all relate to the profile. You can also launch your game by double-clicking the play button in the top left. At the bottom of your screen, you have min-max tuning, axis limiting, parking location, crash detection, and profile intensity. Within your min-max tuning, you have your game limits. By changing these values, you change the sensitivity and intensity of your simulator's movement. Axis limiting allows you to change the range of motion that your axes have. Parking location allows you to change where your simulator sits while it is not in use. Crash detection allows you to change the sensitivity and intensity of motion when a crash occurs. Lastly, your profile intensity allows you to change the intensity of motion for the entire profile. Remember that min-max tuning, crash detection, and profile intensity are all configured per game, while axis limiting and parking location are configured once for the whole simulator. The trash can in the top right allows you to uninstall your plugins. And when you're ready to launch your plugin, double-click the play button. There's a quick overview of your plugin.